He took his switchblade and cut up some bedsheets to tie up the nurses with their hands behind their backs and ankles tied up. He grabbed Pamela Wilkening first, led her to another room to rape her, and ended up killing her because of two nurses coming home unaware from the hostage situation, walked in. He tortured each one before brutally killing them with the switchblade. The gun would have made too much noise. He stabbed each woman about 20 times. Gloria Davey, the last one to die, was raped and then strangled to death. Speck walked right out of the apartment after checking for survivors and threw his switchblade into a nearby body of water surrounding a bridge, believing he had committed the perfect murder. However, Cora Morrow had somehow not been seen by Speck when he left the apartment, and she immediately called the police. Speck's fingerprints on the door were matched to those of the Dallas Police Department's, and an artist's depiction of Speck according to Morrow's description was published in every newspaper nationwide. Meanwhile, Speck had committed murder in his hotel room and almost bled to death when the hotel handyman found him and called 911. Speck was recognized immediately at the hospital from his Born to Raise Hell tattoo.
And there was Born to Raise Hell. And I looked at the nurses and I said, this is the fella that the police are looking for.
After being analyzed by a court-appointed psychologist, Speck was deemed fit for trial. Conveniently, all Speck could recall of the night was being very drunk and getting an injection of speed from a stranger. Speck had become the shy boy he was in grade school when on trial. Amaro's testimony is what closed the case and sent Speck to Stateville Prison in Joliet, Illinois, to await the death penalty. Stateville was no jailhouse rock. Prisoners there were the worst of the worst. For his safety from other prisoners, Speck was moved to the isolation unit of the prison. The Supreme Court later ruled that part of Speck's jury had been potentially excluded. Speck's death penalty was reversed, and he was given 400 to 1,200 years in prison. On December 5, 1991, Speck died of a heart attack after spending more than half his life in prison. Since nobody wanted his body, he was cremated and his ashes were scattered on a field of which only two people know the location of. In 1996, a video from Speck's prison days was released. It showed him discussing the murders and showed his grotesque life behind bars. Speck had had an immense transformation. He had smuggled hormones and grown female-like breasts and walk around in woman's underwear. This was part of survival in one of the country's toughest prisons. He prostituted himself out to prisoners to survive and obtain commodities such as smuggled drugs and liquor. The death penalty might have been a lighter punishment than the years of abuse and humiliation.
This one's for the lonely, the ones that seek and find, only to be let down time after time. This one's for the torn down, the experts at the fall. Come on friends, get up now, you're not alone at all. Oh, 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 oh. For her, and this part was for her, this part was for her, does she remember? It comes and goes in waves. This one's for the faithless, the ones that are surprised, they're only where they are now, regardless of the fight. This one's for believing, if only for its sake. Come on friends, get up now, love is to be made. Oh, 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 oh. And this part was for her, and this part was for her, this part was for her, does she remember?
didn't know he made it. Black horse, Bill. Had no freedom. Dad says I felt sorry. But no.
Often we create a monster out of Richard Speck, and sometimes it is worthwhile to back off and say, well, maybe he wasn't a monster. Maybe he was all too human. That is the most frightening thing of all.